let's now get started with the installation part for kubectl. The path for this is basically you're going to have to download an executable file, change its permission, and add it to your path. This is similar for all the Mac machines, Windows, and Linux systems as well. In this particular video, we'll be looking at the Mac commands, but the guide over here in this particular URL on the official Kubernetes install tools website, it's sort of similar for all these systems. So first thing that we need to do is download the latest Kubernetes kubectl binary with curl. So you can just copy this particular command. I'm going to be using Apple Silicon. That's why it says ARM over here. If you're using Intel, it would be saying AMD. So just copy this and paste it over here. So you can see it's downloading the latest release now. The next step is also, if you want to download a specific release, you can replace it with the particular version that you want to use. You can also validate the binary, but this step is totally optional, and you can download the checksum file and it should show kubectl OK as an output when we validate it. So let's try to run this. It will show me kubectl OK. The next thing is that we have to make this kubectl binary executable, because whenever we're running commands like this, they are usually stored in like your path variables. And whenever you type some command like, you know, kubectl or let's say, for example, the simplest commands like git. So these are all executables that are stored in your path. So first thing we need to do is make it an executable. So I can just change the permissions for that. And now it's executable because it's in my current directory right now, but it's not in my path. So that is the another step that we need to do. We need to move this particular file into our path, on our system path. So let me just copy this and paste. Now it's in my particular path. If you want to see, if you want to list your particular path, you can see user, local, bin. Yep, you can say grep kubectl. So you can see it's available over here. You can also echo my path. As you can see, my user local bin is available over here. So whenever I type kubectl, it's gonna give me this particular, it says green over here, means this command is valid because I'm using item. So this particular thing, it's gonna search it in my path, which is here. That's how environment variables work. So you can see it's particularly installed. I also need to change owner for this. So I can just do that via this command, and that is done. The next thing is I already did that, but let's validate it again. Okay, so now we're able to see the particular output, and our kubectl is very installed now. But this particular output is very ugly, and it's in a very unreadable format. Fortunately, kubectl, we can use a few different formats for its output. For example, we can use YAML file. So I can just say another flag like output is equal to YAML. Now this is a much more clean way, and it's much more readable. Cool. So that was about installing kubectl. And the next step for us to do is the installation of Minikube.